Aerial views of Minnesota communities and a scene of two women talking in an office are seen as the narrator speaks.
In the past several years, Minnesota has been transitioning to a person-centered support system for home and community-based services. Person-centered practices. We use person-centered practices because they focus on each person's abilities and strengths and increase people's quality of life. People who receive home and community-based waiver services have the right to choose which services they want to receive, who delivers the services, and where and how often the services are delivered. In Minnesota, we encourage people to be involved and engaged in making these important decisions.
A title screen appears that shows a Minnesota Department of Human Services logo with text below that reads, Home and Community-Based Services, Person-Centered Services.
Here are some ways providers in Minnesota are providing person-centered services.
A Welcome to Willmar sign is seen, followed by a view of the Bethesda Daybreak building. The scene fades to a woman sitting in a large dining room. Text appears that says, Cindy Wilkins, Program Director, Bethesda Daybreak.
My mission is to find that person-centered care. I always say to my gals, when we have 40 people here, we have 40 different people here, and we need to make sure that we're trying to meet their needs as an individual.
Cindy is seen talking to an elderly man, and then the scene fades to Cindy and another woman helping two elderly men repair a chair.
And, you know, everybody has a goals and interests and like, and I feel like when they come here, they know that they're getting that.
The scene fades back to Cindy in the dining room.
They know that when they want to play dice, we're going to find someone to play dice with them.
Cindy is seen helping a woman off the bus, and then the scene fades back to Cindy in the dining room.
I want people to come here and feel that they have a quality of life and they have value and there is a mission and to stay healthy and stay active. But I love my job. I love what I do.
The scene fades to a Welcome to Detroit Lakes sign, followed by a view of the Ecumen Detroit Lakes building. The scene fades to a woman sitting in an office. Text appears that says, Kylie Johnson, Housing and Direct Day Services Manager.
It's really important to know the residents that we serve and be creative, have fun, enjoy them while they're here, provide those meaningful activities, and if there's an opportunity to do something, try it.
The scene fades to a different woman sitting in the office. Text appears that says, Anita Bendixson, Clinical Director.
And then just really getting to know the client and having an open mind, flexibility, creativity, to really focus on that patient-centered care. And just through conversation, you might spark an idea.
An elderly man in a wheelchair is seen next to his garden. And then the scene fades to a woman sitting in the office. Text appears that says, Kelly Jensen, Adult Day Service Program.
Some of the things you don't think that they could do anymore or are available to them, they really are.
An elderly man is seen with his woodworking projects, and then the scene fades back to Anita.
We have a couple people that really enjoy woodworking, whether it's running a screwdriver or anything that feels really gives them purpose. It brings back a passion and a confidence that they had.
Individualizing their care plan in a way that, I mean, he was a previous woodworker. The staff spend a lot of time just thinking of different projects to keep that woodworking ability in place and really making that client happy.
The scene fades to Kelly.
Anytime you can take somebody and make their day better and they can look you in the eye and they thank you and you know you've made a difference in their life, that is huge.
The scene fades to the elderly man with his woodworking projects.
And this is a whole lot more fun than just playing by yourself.
A Welcome to Browerville flag on a light pole above an intersection is seen, followed by the front of the STEP building. A sign on the front of the building reads, STEP, Serving, Teaching, and Empowering People, 501 West 6th Street. The scene fades to a woman sitting in an office. Text appears that says, Connie Sincella, Designated Coordinator, STEP.
I think that we just need to all just stop and just hear what somebody is telling us. Go in with your ears tuned in to them, hear any little clue that you can hear.
A female employee at the thrift store is seen organizing the shoe rack and dressing the mannequins.
I've had a consumer that has been with STEP on three different occasions. This time when she came back, I just took a whole new outlook on what she was really looking for and what she really needed. And she was telling me how she likes to be creative. And I asked her if she would like to dress our female mannequins in the store. And she became real excited about that. So she picks out the clothing, she picks out the accessories that go, and she is able to express some of her creativity. And that was a big desire of hers. She wanted to be creative, wants to be independent.
The scene fades back to Connie.
And is willing to go through the work to get there. So we need to look at the little things to build up to the big. And it takes time.
A sign in a park is seen with text that says, Mankato, now playing. Visit MankatoMN.com, followed by the front of the Ecumen Pathstone Crossing building. The scene fades to a woman sitting in the lobby. Text appears that says, Amanda Bevins, housing manager.
Person-centered planning is important because not everyone is the same, and we want to treat people as individuals, and they want to be treated as individuals.
The scene fades to a different woman in the lobby. Text appears that says, Wilbur Nushonder Frank, Pathstone Living Volunteer.
Supporting people on an individual level is critical. Every person inside of them has gifts and talents and purpose that they can give to the world.
The scene fades to a different woman in the lobby. Text appears that says, Leah Kies Hugeback, Life Enrichment Specialist.
So we need to be aware of that and make sure we're serving our population the best that we can. Know your audience, know who you're serving.
The scene fades to an elderly woman talking to a younger woman, and then fades back to Amanda.
So looking at the things that they want to do in their life is very important.
I feel like our team members do a great job, especially our life enrichment team, in really getting to know the residents.
The scene fades to Leah.
So I think a really important thing to do to get the person-centered plan is to build trust, build those relationships, sit down, get to know the residents. I think once you build that relationship, they're more likely to open up with you.
The scene fades to Wilbur.
And again, it's that exuding of respect towards the person.
An aerial view of the town of Buffalo is seen, followed by the lobby of the Functional Industries building. The scene fades to a woman sitting in a conference room. Text appears that says, Lisa Partey, President of Client Services at Functional Industries.
And so today when we look at person-centered planning, it's that person guiding the team and telling the team what it is they want, and then us assisting them to make the plan to get to where they want to go. Someone here who's doing rec and leisure said, tomorrow I want a job in the community. We're going to figure it out. We're going to make it happen.
An aerial view of the town is seen, and then the scene fades back to Lisa.
Carrie came to us. Carrie said, I want a job in the community. I want to get married. I want to live independently. Well, today she's got her independent job. She's engaged. When she first came here, she was on very structured behavioral plans.
A scene of two people's hands pointing and writing on paperwork is seen, and then the scene fades back to Lisa.
We've been able to put the supports in place for her to be able to realize her dreams. It took her a little while, but she did it.
A different woman is seen sitting in the conference room. Text appears that says, Carrie Gerber, employee, Functional Industries.
Was going on crew a lot more. I had opportunities to go to all different places.
The scene fades back to Lisa.
Once she was out on crew, she decided, you know what, if I can do this, I can go and I can work my own job in the community.
The scene fades back to Carrie.
I worked with a job coach from Functional to get me a job outside of Functional. I now work at a gym in called Fitness Evolution in Monticello.
The scene fades back to Lisa.
I think what's really interesting about Carrie's journey is that we watched grow into this person we never thought she could be.
A water tower that says Melrose on it is seen, followed by a view of the CentraCare Health building. A sign in front of the building reads, CentraCare Health, Melrose, Parkview Center. The scene fades to a woman sitting in the lobby. Text appears that says Jennifer Ohmscheid, Senior Housing Manager.
It isn't a place that we regulate what you do, how you do it. You come and you live here. You are able to bring the things that you want to here, decorate your apartment like you would your own home. We had a lady that was really hesitant on moving in.
A garden surrounding a fountain is seen outside of the building, and then the scene fades back to Jennifer.
And I said, well, what were the things that were really important to you at home? What do you want to take with you? And she said, my perennial gardens, the flowers. I loved gardening. I said, you know what? Let's find you a place. And we found her a place to garden. And it actually looks right out her window of her apartment. So she can go. She takes good care of that garden. So it's very important to her. So trying to find the things that are important to the people that move in here and bring that with them and be able to give them the things that they would have when they live at home. Everybody has a different need. We can't group everybody in the same category. We really base each person's needs on where they are at and make sure we can meet those needs.
A title screen appears that shows a Minnesota Department of Human Services logo with text below that reads, Home and Community-Based Services, Person-Centered Services.